you know that here in Cambridgeshire, we've got some of the most high-powered radio telescopes in the country? You probably know that if you ever travel the A603 out of Cambridge, heading down towards Barton. But we've also got one of the biggest telescope showrooms in Europe as well. Johnny D in the radio car is at Astronomy and Nature at Wychford near Ely. And he joins us today on BBC Radio Cambridgeshire as we get excited about the moon, the stars and the sun and heavenly bodies.
Good morning, Sue. The lovely sound of David Bowie. That's great stuff. I'm about 3 miles from Ely, Sue. And if I wanted to have a close look at the great Ship of the Fens, the cathedral, of course, I'm in the right place. I'm surrounded by the most amazing array of telescopes, binoculars, and observatories as well. Observatories are a bit like obese Daleks that have eaten too much intergalactic Christmas pud. They really are. And I'm absolutely amazed. It's the size of a tennis court, huge place here, and from the outside looks like a great big DIY shop like you'd find in Peterborough, Cambridge, or any other major town or city. I've got me the director of Astronomy and Nature Centre, Robert Dolby. Now, Robert, how come one of the biggest telescope suppliers in Europe is in Wychford?
Well, everybody's got to be somewhere. With today's trading on the internet, we really don't need to be anywhere in particular, as long as we've got a big warehouse and somewhere to be, which is a good place. Good skies as well in Norfolk.
Now, at the moment, of course, BBC stargazing TV coverage, has that inspired lots of people to look up to the skies?
Yeah, I'd say it's been unprecedented. We normally see a good pickup of interest in astronomy with if the BBC covers a comet or something like that. But this has been absolutely unprecedented. We've probably had the biggest response from the public in the last couple of days, I think, frankly, than we've ever seen, you know, in the last 15 years.
You are an astronomer yourself, of course. Why do you love it so much, Robert?
Well, the universe is a big place, and it's fairly difficult to distill that very simple question down to a single sentence. But I think it's probably something to do with the hair on the back of your neck standing up. You know, getting a sense of awe. Looking up at the night sky is totally unspoiled. It's not something that's really got anything to do with what we do down here. And it's just, you know, something you can get into that is just utterly awesome. And that's where astronomy is.
And today, unfortunately, we've been outside. It's quite dark, so, but the clouds are there, aren't they?
Yeah, they're not complying for us, unfortunately, as much. It's one of the big annoyances of astronomy. As good as your equipment is, if the clouds move in, you're stuffed, basically.
Now, do people have to spend thousands of pounds? Say they've seen this stargazing television programme, they've got inspired, want to get into it themselves, have they got to part with lots of dosh?
No, definitely not. You start astronomy, all you need to do is walk outside on a dark, clear night and look up. It's as simple as that. So really, spending money is not the essential ingredient to get involved in astronomy. The good news is that the getting involved with equipment has probably never been better. There's probably more available today than ever before, and you can participate with equipment starting at £25, or going up to £50,000, as much as you've got, really, and as little.
And behind us, you've got a projection of a beautiful-looking planet. I'm not sure what it is myself. What is that?
Jupiter. That's Jupiter you're looking at there.
And it's lovely. I've never seen that. That is the actual colour of it. It's sort of a brown.
It is, yeah. You know, when you look through a telescope, you see Jupiter during its day, so it's lit by the sun. And how it looks in the telescope is how it is. And those are the details you can actually see. I mean, the amount of detail you've got on the screen there is within the reach of, say, a 12-inch telescope, 12-inch aperture telescope.
Absolutely superb. I tell you what, it's been great to meet you. And unfortunately, the closest star I'm going to get to today, I'm afraid, is Sue Dugan.
Oh, stop.
So this is Johnny D in Wychford, BBC Cambridgeshire.
Starry skies. Robert and Johnny, thank you very much today.